8:23 on this Thursday morning with Dr. Yvette Liu, and I've been looking so forward to this conversation, Doctor, mostly because there are so many people who are afraid to go to the doctor and get the regular medical marker tests that really can be life-saving.
Definitely. If you do the tests on time and do them regularly, we can really prevent and treat disease early.
Okay, so give us some ideas. You're taking us both male and female through various age groups of where do we start?
Yes, so first we're going to start with medical markers that are important for all adults. So these are things like blood pressure, checking your cholesterol, getting screened regularly for sexually transmitted infections, your body mass index, which is your height to weight ratio, getting all your immunizations, especially tetanus, which is every 10 years. A lot of people forget about that.
Right.
Checking your skin for atypical moles and signs of skin cancer, and then of course regular dental care.
People don't realize how much your dentist is so important to your overall health, and so that's all ages, male and female.
Yes, and then now we're going to go into each age group.
Okay.
So we're going to start with women in their 20s to 30s, and you want to start cervical cancer screening. So make sure you do your Pap test every 1 to 2 years. Starts at the age of 21 or 3 years after first sexual contact. Folic acid is very important for pregnant women, and you want to start folic acid 2 to 3 months before you get pregnant, so your body has enough folic acid already when you are pregnant. That's really important for neural tube development, brain and spinal cord development in the baby. Clinical breast exams, which are breast exams done by a doctor or a nurse who's trained, are now optional because we don't have good evidence that they prevent death from breast cancer. So if you want to do them, you can do them every 1 to 3 years, but you don't have to.
For women in their 20s or 30s. Okay,
yeah.
And next?
And then next, we can go on to men and women in their 40s. Now, this is when you want to start to think about diabetes screening. Most guidelines recommend screening between the ages of 40 to 45 or testing based on your risk factors.
Is that a blood test?
It's a blood test.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's pretty straightforward. Talk to your doctor to see if you're high risk.
Don't be afraid to talk to your doctor.
No, it's just a blood test. A lot of people are scared of needles, but it's really not that bad.
Just wiggle your toes. My mom was a lab tech. She taught me.
Oh,
just wiggle your toes when you're getting that blood work done. Okay, what's up next?
Going on to men and women, for women in their 40s. We'll talk about this first. So optional mammograms every 2 years from age 40 to 50. And this is because we don't have good evidence that the benefit outweighs the risk between 40 and 50. And then after 50, we do recommend mammograms every 2 years until the age of 75. After the age of 75, it's every 2 or 3 years based on your health status.
And again, if you've never had a mammogram, they also do not hurt.
Right. And you want to, if you are at high risk of breast cancer, then you want to do it every year starting at age 40. So if you have a first degree relative, mother, sister, or daughter with breast cancer, then it's every year.
Right. Okay.
So now I think we're going on to the 50s, people in their 50s.
Yes.
So colon cancer screening, a stool test every 1 to 2 years. That's usually for low-risk people, or a colonoscopy every 5 years for people at high risk until the age of 75.
My mother is a colon cancer survivor. I have both of those tests done,
right.
And it's easy. And there's so much comfort in knowing that you're okay.
And I think that's the main point for a lot of these tests that we're talking about, is that they're pretty easy to do.
Right, comforting. And moving on to the next board,
heart
we go.
Heart disease.
Yes.
Heart disease.
Checking.
That's
heart
when you
disease.
Want to start thinking about heart disease at the age of 50. Prevalence goes up at the age of 45 and at the age of 45 for men and at the age of 55 for women.
And what is that test like?
It's really just a screening for risk factors. So you want to make sure that you get your blood pressure checked, cholesterol checked, and make sure you prevent anything that you can, like quit smoking, weight loss, make sure you're doing your exercise.
Right. Keep that heart moving. Use it or lose it. And one more board we have for...
In your 60s.
Yes.
Yes. So shingles vaccine. Shingles is a very painful blistering rash that can cause chronic long-term pain long after the rash is gone. There's an immunization for that. Pneumococcal vaccine, which helps you prevent pneumonia after the age of 65. Abdominal aortic aneurysm. A lot of people don't know about this one. This is a swelling of the blood vessel that supplies your body, and it can burst and cause you to die.
Wow.
So between the ages of 65 and 75, especially for men, and then a vision check.
What's involved in that screening?
Oh, it's just an abdominal ultrasound.
Okay.
So once again,
very easy. Painless.
Yes.
Great information. We're going to put all of this on our Facebook page. Of course, you can follow Dr. Yvette Liu. You can go to the website. Screeningbc.ca is a great resource for everyone. And CanadaTaskForce.ca, another one. Great information. Good information for us today. Just go and talk to your doctor and get checked out. Make sure they're thorough. We have healthcare for a reason in this country, and we can make everybody pay less overall if we do these screenings. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
As always.